Ganz am Anfang bei der ersten Arabesque-Piqué Beinstrecken. Hinteres. Bei dem Dirty. Nochmal.
La vie est une pièce autobiographique.
La vie is an autobiographical piece of work. A girl who turns into a woman, a father who loses his daughter to her lovers, and the separation of the grown-up woman from her father, from her husband. I have been dealing with this topic for some years now, the change of generations, the taboo about growing older, a topic which has rarely been dealt with in dance. I wanted to work with older people, with former dancers, as I am growing older myself, both as a woman and a dancer, and I have to face this fact permanently.
Ce projet a pris corps depuis la rencontre avec Jean Babelet que je ne connaissais qu'au travers.
I met Jean Babelet, whose name I had really known from a dance dictionary, in Paris. A friend of mine is talking about him, gives me his phone number, I call him, he has got a nice and friendly voice. We fix an appointment. I arrive at his flat. We talk for 3 hours and then my heart is bursting with joy. Jean Babelet is going to dance for me.
Il a regardé les vidéos de mes travaux chorégraphiques et il a accepté. C'était comme un rêve. Sorti de ce rendez-vous, je ne savais que faire de ma joie. Jean Babelet allait danser pour moi. Passage à l'acte. Première répétition à Paris.
The first rehearsals took place in Paris. About half of the play was created there. And here in Salzburg, the rehearsal period was to be completed. We start without Babelet, having arranged that he would be with us 2 weeks later. On the day when he is supposed to arrive, he calls me early in the morning and tells me that there was this thunderstorm and that they had to spend the night in Innsbruck. The 70-year-old Babelet, his 35-year-old girlfriend Sappo, and the 2-year-old cat Billy are riding their motorbikes from Avignon to Salzburg. They arrive around lunchtime. Babelet is still soaked to the skin from the journey, but he is full of energy. He likes the theater, smells the stage, and wants to start right away, as he is dressed in shirt jeans and wet linen shoes.
« Jean Babilé est le danseur français le plus célèbre de l'après-guerre.
Jean Babilé is the most important French dancer of the period after the war, who can be classified among other legendary names of classical dance in our century, such as Nijinsky, Nureyev, Baryshnikov. He's dancing for the first time in his life a pas de deux with a man, and for the first time he's dancing barefoot. It was a moving moment when one day during a rehearsal he takes off his dancing shoes and very carefully, as if he were just about to learn how to walk, tries the new and unfamiliar contact with the ground.
Jean Babilé réunit pour moi dans une même personnalité le professeur.
For me, Jean Babilé's personality is a combination of teacher, father, husband and child. It's also no coincidence that he agreed immediately to work with me. The things he has in common with my father are amazing. Not only do they resemble each other physically, they are also alike in small details, such as their love for cats and animals, the fascination for clocks and objects with a fine mechanics.
Dans ce travail, je n'ai pas rencontré l'homme difficile.
The fierce temper of Jean Babilé that is mentioned in the books can hardly be noticed in the course of our cooperation. Or maybe, when he's dancing, when he vigorously starts to spin, in his face how furious he can be at times when something is not working out straight away.
Je suis intéressée par l'individualité de mes danseurs.
I'm interested in the individuality of dancers, the fact that they cannot be exchanged. The cast of La Vie is not only unique because of Jean Babilé, but also because of Georg Blaschke, Eva Forsten-Lechner, and of the 13-year-old Evold Starnstedt. In all the three of them, I can see part of my own history. When I'm choreographing, Georg and I form an alliance. We communicate without having to talk. His subtlety and energy fit his role in the production precisely. Eve moves her gangling body with innocence, security, self-confidently, and without shyness. Eva's part is one of a young woman, and she is radiating a natural lust for life. The beauty in her presence touches me again and again.
Pas qu'elle sache ce que je vais faire. Mm-hmm. Just have it for me. I take it. You don't know that's going to happen.
Yes. And then the idea is she wants to get you to play with her.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes?
Yeah, sure. Mm-hmm.
Tu résistes un peu, mais...
Non, mais ce que tu as fait tout à l'heure, c'est que tu as pris la main droite, tu as lâché et tu as donné la gauche.
Oui, c'était par hasard.
Non, mais c'était mieux, parce que c'est pas mieux comme ça.
Ok, ok. Alors, j'ai mis quoi, la main gauche et après la main droite. Wie bist du für dich sehr gemacht?
Tu prends la main droite.
Take
this. Take this hand.
You take this hand. And then it the change. Ah, take this.
Lors des répétitions, je laisse toujours une porte ouverte au hasard.
When I'm rehearsing, the door is open for the unexpected, for a sudden new idea, the mood of a particular moment. I load my body with emotions that unload spontaneously during the rehearsal.
Mes mouvements sont toujours intentionnels.
The movements come by intentions, loaded by emotions. I watch my dances in private moments, and sometimes I quickly pick up something for the use in a scene.
Je pense qu'une pièce a besoin d'être maturée.
I think that a piece has to grow. Often I understand my scenes only after weeks. This is why I try to assemble scenes quickly, make run-throughs.
Ah, d'accord.
en général, j'aimerais que les guerres soient plus virils. Parce que guerre, ça doit se donner erstaunt en chose. Ça doit se donner c'est confrontation. C'est une confrontation. C'est vraiment la rencontre de deux mecs de virilité différents qui ont vécu différentes choses. Mais, tu vois. Alors, surtout c'est plus les regards. Les mouvements, c'est fort. Mais les regards, c'est ça.
Je vous présente Billy, le chat de Jean Babély.
This is Billy, Jean Babély's cat. When I visited him in Paris, I was terribly nervous, but Billy accepted me immediately.
Ici, elle essaie d'établir un contact avec Isolde.
Here she's trying to get in touch with my cat Isolde. Not so easy.
Jean est un véritable conteur.
Jean is a good storyteller, and sometimes his passionate anecdotes are on the edge between reality and fairy tale. He has known many great and important people.
Maurice Béjart, Michael Baryshnikov, Luchino Visconti, Peter Brook, Alberto Giacometti, Boris Vian, Pablo Picasso. Sa carrière est impressionnante.
He was danseur étoile at the opera in Paris, star of the American Ballet Theatre. He has danced almost every important classical role, but was a successful choreographer for his own company also.
Jean est un être unique. Danseur, chorégraphe, doublé de narrateur.
Jean is dancer, choreographer, storyteller. He presents his anecdotes with humor and modesty.
Une autre anecdote. Pressé par son directeur d'alors de trouver un titre à la création.
Jean makes his first ballet. He starts working. The director encourages him to have the opening night very quickly. Therefore, he has to know the title the next day. Jean has no idea. In his desperation, he calls Jean Cocteau, who invites him for dinner. And while Cocteau is stirring the salad with his long fingers, he's talking to himself, and after the meal, Babély has title, costumes, and the set for his play.
C'est vraiment ce qu'on peut voir de plus beau, le Calas qui était amoureux de lui.
J'ai vu ça.
J'ai vu 5 fois Traviata.
Non, oui. Avec Calas.
Ouais, mis en scène par Visconti, décor de Lila de Nobili.
Qui?
Le décor de Lila de Nobili. Oui. On ne peut pas imaginer plus beau. Les somnambules, là, j'ai vu. Dirigé par Bernstein.
D'autres histoires qui d'ailleurs étonnent beaucoup Georg.
Georg is amazed as Jean tells that he never did warm-ups before going on stage, just 3 or 4 pliés. One day, having a performance at the Scala di Milano, he rides there from Paris with his motorbike and arrives just in time to dash on stage. drives back to Paris after the applause.